on this episode of LaPeef, let's talk.
Cinderella.
Chicago, I would love to hear the answer.
Hey, let me, hey, real talk. Let me tell y'all this, fam. Let me tell y'all this. And I'm sitting up here and I really been chilling. I literally listen to all of y'all. And I hear you, Anton. And I listen to the lady speak. And I see you, Kay. I see you with your cute faces and all that. And what's crazy is the only person, and I hear you with Kiki and the this, that, and the third.
I'm not
Kayla, Kaylee, I'm Kayla, much respect to you and all of that, right? And the only thing that only person I see it keeping it balanced and 100 right now in the conversation that we having is Crimson, right?
Okay, but you're not. You're
gonna, no, okay. I'm not finna do that with you, fam, because I let you rock. I
do it with Anton. He just said
what
it,
I would prefer
he's
you
100%
do.
Right.
No, he's 100% right according to you.
So what, he had a bunch of kids, and if he's taking care of his kids, okay, what's wrong?
Nah.
You think okay. Can I get in here?
I'm gonna be patient this time. Go ahead.
Okay. Listen, okay. I have to disagree with that. I believe that men that are hoes go through. I'm sorry, I don't know if I can say that.
You can say that here.
Men that are promiscuous. definitely deal with issues. I don't think it's a by chance thing. I think that they are less likely to be successful being monogamous. I think that it develops unrealistic expectations because they're used to Becky doing this thing and Sandra doing that thing and Keisha doing this thing and Angela doing that thing. And then now one woman has to brunt all of these things that this man has become accustomed to by being able to go and get it whenever he want to go get it. So I don't see, these men usually aren't good at monogamy. Monogamy takes practice. You don't just wake up one day, you know what?
But we're assuming
this girl is the one.
Assuming that they have to be,
you know, I'm never going to cheat. I'm never going to look at another woman. It's just so crazy. That's not how it works. You have to practice the things that you have to do in order to avoid situations, how to handle situations if they come around. And it takes time. So I do think that men, I don't think it's a by chance. Men that are out here with a lot of women, at the end of the day, whoever you lay down with, you're equal to them. So they deal with the same thing that women that are doing that deal with the same thing psychologically. I believe that men do deal with the same things.
I agree.
Cool. Well, Kayla, well, let me add, wait.
I don't real think quick, men are just out here.
Real quick.
Hold on. Let Crimson respond back and then we'll come to you, okay? I got you. I promise.
I'm gonna keep it brief. The only thing that I wanted to say is that we're assuming that at some point a man has to be monogamous or that he doesn't have to.
You're assuming at some point.
Because all relationships don't even operate on monogamy.
Okay, that's fine. I mean, for me, I'm talking, if you don't operate on monogamy, I don't see the issue with you going out here and doing your thing. Go do your thing. If you're a woman and you don't want to be monogamous, go do your thing. If you're a man, you don't want to be, do your thing. But if your ultimate goal is to build a family, a legacy with someone, and have a lifetime partnership with someone, that shit ain't going to be rainbows and stuff the whole time. It's going to have ups and downs, and you have to be able to prepare yourself to deal with that emotionally, mentally, physically. And if you're always the type of person that just goes somewhere else to get what you need, I don't see how you're going to be able to do that effectively.
Agreed.
So we just going to act like polygyny now?
I don't know. I don't subscribe to anything outside of monogamy, so I don't know.
Well, Crimson,
whatever. Go ahead, polygamous. Do your thing.
No, Crimson, I agree. It's perfectly fine.
I really coming to you
for people that want to be in these situations with multiple whatever. I'm not against that at all. I advocate for it. Do it. Whatever is good for you. All I'm saying is that we cannot act like promiscuity and all these things only affect women.
What?
We can't. All men are just fine with all this.
I agree with that, Kay.
Stuff that they 1,000%. Go through in life.
But that's not.
Wait. Hold on.
Men are humans.
Yo, please.
Men
please.
Are humans too.
Please.
I advocate for men. Men are humans, and they absolutely suffer trauma. They absolutely go through nonsense. We can't just be like, man can do it. Yo, no, right.
Let me, no. Let, no, I hear you.
Hold on, hold on, hold on. Let Rilla cook for
no,
me.
No, 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 no.
Kay is dead on.
I hear you. Kay
is dead on bullseye right.
Okay, cool. Let me 1,000%. Know. Okay, cool.
You can talk. Okay, you can cool. talk, but listen, listen, yeah. Rilla, what you got to understand, fam, is that
I'm not.
Hold on, listen.
Nope.
You got to lower your voice and strengthen your argument.
I hear
just
you.
Because
that,
you just because you're talking know, louder does not necessarily mean that the point don't hit you. Anymore.
No,
we're not talking about beating. I'm just saying, you. Rilla, look.
I'm with you.
You can make your point. I'm gonna respond. I'm just saying, like, just because we loud, that does not necessarily mean. Okay, do your thing.
What point was he making? I want to hear, because I don't even know what he was even.
Nah, really, what I want to hear what you're making, because literally what I've been hearing you talk about, young lady, really, I haven't heard you take accountability for the role that women play in promiscuity. Oh my gosh, Kay. I can't.
What is Kayla supposed to do?
What do you mean? The first thing I said was yes.
Hold on. Let me say something. Give me
a management.
Give me a second, Kayla.
Hold on, y'all.
Give me a second. So Rilla, are you saying that because I agree with what Crimson said, largely, especially with regard to women, right? But it's not a one-sided conversation when we start to dive down a rabbit hole to better understand how other people operate. Because the problem that I have is that a lot of women think that they can operate like men. I don't think that men are as affected as women are when they have multiple partners. But I'd be incredibly naive to think that men are not affected by the amount of sexual partners that they have, regardless of whether they're high quality or low quality. I can't subject myself to that mindset, honestly, if I'm being real with myself.
Yo, listen,
Rilla,
listen,
you just said, hold on, wait, I'm going to ask you a question, Rilla. The first thing that you said on the first thing that you said on the very first subject that we talked about is that if you had to do it all over again, you would be a virgin. It's a reason why you said that.
Exactly.
Why would you say that and then combat what it was that Kay is saying when she says that men are also affected by the amount of sexual partners that they have?
Exactly.
Let the church say, I'm sorry.
Anton, go. I'm about to. Exactly.
Hey, go ahead, Crimson.
Because
no, hold on, I asked the question to Rilla.
Chicago, I would love to hear the answer.
Let me tell y'all this, fam. Let me tell y'all this. And I'm sitting up here and I've really been chilling. I literally listen to all of y'all. And I hear you, Anton. And I listen to the lady speak. And I see you, Kay. I see you with your cute faces and all that. And what's crazy is the only person, and I hear you with the Kiki and the this, that, and the third.
I'm not
Kayla. Kayla, much respect to you and all of that. Right? And the only thing that only person I see it keeping it balanced and 100 right now in the conversation that we having is Crimson, right?
Okay, but you're not.
I'm not finna do that with you, fam, because I let you rock. I
do
let
what
you
Anton. He just said
what
it,
I would prefer
and he's
you
100%
do. 100%
right.
No, he's 100% right according to you.